Hi everyone, I'll start solving problems on reciprocating compressors. First of all, we'll take up one problem which is asked in June-July 2017. So just read the problem here. Determine the size of cylinder of a double acting air compressor of 45 kilowatt in which air is taken in at 1 bar and compressed to 16 bar. According to the law, PV raised to 1.25. See, this is very important. So whatever he has given index, you need to take this 1.25 only. Don't take as 1.4 where we were taking as usual in the earlier problems. If he has given, you should use that only. Assume speed of the crank as 300 rpm, means he has given rpm, n is equal to 300 rpm, and piston speed, this is one very important given data, 180 rpm, this 180 meters per minute, means piston speed or velocity of piston he has given, meters per 180 meters per minute. Volumetric efficiency is 80%, stroke length is 30 centimeters. So given data, you need to convert the things. So what he has given, 45, determine the size of double acting compressor of 45 kilowatt, it is indicated power, 45 kilowatt. Pressure P1 is 1 bar, P2 is 16 bar, compressed to 16 bar he has given already. Index is 1.25, here it is 1.25. Next, n is 300 rpm. Volumetric efficiency is 80%. So this VP is new term for us, that is piston speed. Usually we have seen speed of engine and other things as n, but here it is piston speed, 180 meters per minute. And stroke length, that L is given as 30 centimeters, it is converted to 0.3 meters. So this is our PV diagram for compressor, as we have seen in the theory part. So now we'll see one by one things. So VP is equal to what? Piston speed, I said VP is equal to 2 into length, stroke length into speed. This is the formula, you note down the important formula here. VP is equal to 2 into LN. So this you remember. So from here, L is also given, N is also given, and VP is also this. What is given? I need to calculate L here in this. L is equal to VP by 2N. So 180 speed is given, 200 and 300, it is 0.3 meters already, we have got that L. IP is equal to 2WN by 60, already I have given in the formula while explaining mechanical efficiency, but one more formula we have is 2 into N divided by N minus 1 P1 into VA, that is VA is equal to V1 minus V4, that already I have said, actual volume of air supplied at a static pressure, P2 by P1 pressure ratio, N minus 1 divided by N minus 1 into N divided by 60. So IP is given already in the given data, N is also given, P1 is given, P2 is given, N is small n is given, capital N is given. So substitute everything, only unknown is VA. So only unknown is VA, VA comes to 0.0121 meter cube, right? So we know that volumetric efficiency is equal to actual volume of air supplied to the swept volume. This is the formula, again we have derived volumetric efficiency. So actual volume to the swept volume, actual volume we have calculated here. Efficiency, volumetric efficiency is given in the problem, 0.8. And VS is equal to what we need to calculate. So one equation, one unknown, you can calculate VS is equal to 0.01518 meter cube. So VS is equal to what? Again, swept volume. that is area into length. Area of a cylinder is pi by 4 d square into L. So this is for a single cylinder. So whenever you can, whenever you are substituting Vs in further problems, you should take pi by 4 d square into L into capital N. That is for all the rotations volume is multiplied there, and total volume, swept volume you have got. This is the swept volume of a single rotation it is. So this is just I am explaining in this problem, this is fine. So from this what is known, Vs is calculated pi by 4 d square, d only it is asked in the problem, and L is we have calculated 0.3, our crank length is already given. So this L is equal to 0.3 you substituted here, Vs is substituted here, only d is remaining, you calculate and find out, d comes around 0.2538 meters. So if you solve this much, it is hardly 2-3 step problem, you are getting 10 marks in the examination. So don't leave these all easy problems, you should start solving. Next, one more problem we will see, which is asked in December 2017, January 2018. An air compressor takes in air at 1 bar and 20 degrees Celsius. Compresses it according to law PV raised to 1.2. In the previous problem it was 1.25, here it is 1.2. So air is delivered to a receiver at a constant pressure of 10 bar. Determine the temperature at the end of the compression, work done and heat transferred during compression per kg of air. Per kg of air means per kg will take m as 1 kg. So neglect clearance, and R is equal to 0.287 kilojoules per kg Kelvin. So given data you just check here. So P1 is equal to 1 bar, P1 is equal to 20 plus 273, 293 Kelvin, P2 is 10 bar, Vc is neglect, means we are neglecting it and taking as 0. So R is equal to 2.287, M per kg of air he has said here, means 1 kg we are taking, N is equal to 1.2 because here 1.2, T2 we have to find out, and W means work required to compress the air. See here, always whenever we are calculating the work means we are compressing the air, it means we are doing work on the system, means whatever work we will get in terms of compressor, it will be always negative. Whenever we are calculating turbine work in previous chapters, there turbine work was always positive because work was done by the system. Here we are doing on the system, there done by the system. So compressor work is always negative, turbine work is always positive. So this compressor is a work absorbing, turbine is work producing. So Q you need to find out heat transfer. Next we'll go for, this is the PV diagram for this 1 to 2, it is compressed from 1 bar to 10 bar. He is asking temperature at this point 2 and work done to compress this much, heat transfer during compression, right? So we know that compression takes place through polytropic process, and this is the temperature and pressure relation. That is T2 by T1 is equal to P2 by P1 raised to N minus 1 divided by N. We have used this formula in so many chapters, from air standard cycles to gas power, every time we are using this formula. This one we are using. One more we have used is PV raised to gamma is equal to constant. Another one is TV raised to gamma minus 1 is constant, or N minus 1 is constant. From this, T1 is given 293, P2, P1 pressures are given, N is also given, we need to find out T2. So directly you can find out T2. So this is the answer for T2. Now, work done by the compressor, work done on the air, that is formula we know that already, N divided by N minus 1, P MR T1, or it is P1 VA, it will be there, or MR T1, P is equal to MR T1, directly as substituted. Based on the given data, you need to substitute here. Here volume is not given, so you should not take PV here. So directly you take MR T1 because R also is given. So whenever r is given, you should think, should not confuse and leave the problem in between. So p2 by p1 is equal to p2 by p1 raised to n minus 1 divided by n minus 1. So substitute here, n is 1.2 and m is 1 kg, r is 0.287 into 293. So pressure ratio is substitute, you will get around 236.02 kilojoules per kg. Now we'll go for work done is this much, temperature is this much, two given datas, we have findings, we have got the answers. Now third one, heat transfer. So how we should find out the heat transfer? We know first law of thermodynamics, that is Q is equal to W plus E. W plus E, W means work done, E means internal energy. So internal energy we don't know, but we know W. W, I said why negative E has taken, it is work absorbing, not work producing. So it is negative here. Plus E, E is what? Internal energy is equal to MCV T2 minus T1. So M is 1 kg, CV 0.717, T2 T1, T1 is already given, T2 is here. So you found out E 98.23. So this is minus 236, he has taken 0.02 plus 98.3. So minus 137.79 kilojoules per kg, heat is rejected, not heat is supplied. So this is heat rejected by the system, so negative. So this is the end of the problem. How many steps we have solved? One step, two step and three step. But you thing is, you need to know the formulas, you need to have the presence of mind to use the formulas. For to find out T2, you should know that this is the formula. To calculate the work done, this is the formula. And while substituting here, don't directly substitute positive value because it is a negative work and you will get the answer in the negative term. So this is how you need to solve the problem. Very simple problems are there. Single formula, you need to use this work done. Formula, so many problems are not there in this problem. Only this formula and Vs is equal to pi by 4 d square ln. So these are the some 2-3 problems, formulas are there in this problem. So this is how you need to solve. So thank you for watching the video.